Today we are accepting donations for our backpack program as well as our food pantries throughout Queen Anne's County.
We are actually continuing to provide weekend meals.
This evening we have a collaborative effort on the part of some of the teachers here at Sutter's Elementary School.
I know throughout the week they have other food distribution sites around the county, but the one we're doing right now, today is the first that I've been a part of.
There are families here with young children, and you know, it's hard to imagine what they are going through right now. So it's, I'm glad that we're doing it, but it's in many ways sad to see because of what we're going through right now.
We have tables set up full of food for the families that need to come and pick up meals that usually get meals during the school year, so we want to continue to provide for those families.
We have a lot of things going from bread, eggs, turkey. We have a lot of snacks, chips, crackers, pasta, anything you can think of, really.
Yeah, so this is a fantastic effort. It's great to see the community getting involved.
So we're in the process of acquiring enough inventory to do it. So far we've had some generous donations. We have some people who are doing bulk shopping for us. The county, and this is really important to know, Queen Anne's County Commissioners every year allocate significant funds to support the Backpacks program.
The Local Management Board, which is a county function, who's just stepped up, my fellow commissioners and I have voted on committing another $10,000 to the program. You know, we have folks that now that their kids are home and they're not at school, there's a much larger need now for this backpack program or programs independent like this that the school's doing here.
Initially, when this whole pandemic started, schools that were actually operating with 40% either reduced lunch or free lunch programs were the sites that were located that we could open up through the Board of Ed. And Laura, from the kindness of her heart, saw that there was a need.
So when the schools shut down, they gave us about 3 days worth of trying to figure out what to do with their kids. So a lot of parents were still working, and I found a need that the kids still needed to get their meals, but most parents were working during the time between 12 and 2 when the meals were for pickup. So I tried to find a solution, and I made it myself.
A lot of families are not able to get to the sites, and so they've been helping to fill that gap, and they collected a lot of food and some cash donations as well.
We started collecting food at 2 locations, at Poor House in Chester and Mama Mia's, and then we brought it all back here and to my house and started bagging up lunches. So now that the Board of Education can now take on the load, we actually gave all the food and donated food to the QAC Backpacks for Kids program.
So in this way, we're taking care of these kids 7 days a week. Now, keep in mind, there are still some people that don't have licenses or can't get to those stops. You need to reach out to us because we're here for you, and we do have people that can make those runs.
So it's a great effort. Everybody is recognizing the situation that our community is in, and they're stepping up and they want to help. And a lot of times the questions are just, how can I?
A local bakery just delivered to us today 1,000 loaves of bread.
All the citizens in the county have been bringing us different kinds of food donations. A lady that works at Bob Evans, since they had to close down, brought us eggs, milk, hash browns.
We've had a van that's been donated by Preston Ford
to transport goods from the south part of the county here to the north part of the county. A lot of donations are being made down there and being trucked up to here.
If they want to bring us food, Rita's is open from noon to 8 daily. You can drop it off here. You can drop it off at your local churches or contact the local schools.
Queen Anne's Conservation Association just this week established an emergency relief fund using the nonprofit designation that we have so that people can contribute. And that money will be earmarked for this purpose. You can go to our Facebook page and get details on that. You can contact me direct.
We've even said, if you want to donate, that's great, these items. If you're out there and you see these items and you want to purchase to help us and bring us a receipt and put your name and address on it, we'll reimburse you.
It's refreshing to see the community step up like they are and ask, how can I help?
You know, at the end of the day, we are all in this together, and it's going to take a community to help everyone. That's the best thing about this whole entire experience, is that it's pulling the whole community together.
Just try to reach out to them as much as we can and try to keep working, because that's all we know. We're teachers and we want to help our students.
Get out and help, because right now, as I say, it's going to take a whole community to help in this effort. And for those people that are advantaged and you still have your jobs and you're still getting a salary, please help, because there are a ton of people right now that have lost their jobs, that are literally hanging by a thread. And right now they need help.